Today we are going to see how we can use ChatGPT for SAP. So first we need to have a ChatGPT account. So go to ChatGPT and click on ChatGPT. If you already have an account, you know how to use and all. If you don't have an account and you want to try and explore, so click on ChatGPT here. And it will give you two options, login and the sign up. We'll go with sign up option. Then give the email ID. So currently I will take the same email ID of this YouTube channel and I will keep it and will continue. Then it will ask for a password. We'll give some random password. And then click on continue. We'll keep it safe. Then verify your Gmail ID. We'll send an email. Okay. Just go to your email ID. Then verify it. This is just a verification. And click on verify email address. Give all your details here. Currently, I will pause for a few minutes. If needed, you can type your details here. What you can give. I'm just giving any dummy details here. Click on continue and select the mobile number. So I need to pause here for a moment because I don't want to share the contact details and all.
Yeah, after entering your contact details, so the first page you will see like this. Click on next, next, done. Okay. So your ChatGPT is now ready to explore. So for there are a few questions I have entered so that to check whether we can use ChatGPT for our SAP use or not. So there are the few questions I already typed here. So we'll check with the basics and then we'll try to explore more from your side also. You can try. So let's say whether it is giving the details properly or not. So I will just enter the some of the details which we already use. So what is the full form of SAP? So it is giving the correct details. Then let's see the second questions, how we can configure company code. So now I am trying to check whether it can give me a details to the users who don't know how to do a configuration of SAP company code. So let's see whether it's possible to, whether it is giving the correct details or not. So it has generated many, much of information. So we'll see whether this information is capable of creating a company code or not. So it's saying that navigate to SAP implementation guide, go to SPRO or going to SPRO SAP reference MG and go to financial accounting configuration. And company code configuration is primarily done with a financial accounting module. Yeah, so enterprise structure, under enterprise structure. So this fourth point is correct. Yeah, under finance enterprise structure, we'll go to the enterprise structure and then we define company and assign a company code. Yeah, I was asking about company code, but this is giving information about the company. So there is much more details need to be defined company. Yeah. Anyhow, this is a proper node in under enterprise structure only. We'll have a company code and the company details. So at least like it's giving some details where we can do it, but the person who has already done it can understand and can do it. But the freshers who never touched SAP cannot be useful for him. Okay, so next question, let's say if I want to understand more details of some information, like we have three chart of accounts, right? So let's types of chart of accounts, how the chart GPT gives the answer for the types of chart of accounts. So click here on the right hand arrow. So it will throw up some details here on the chart of accounts. So I'll scroll down a bit. Types of chart of account. It's a question we have asked, and it is giving me all the details of chart of account. The first one is operational chart of account. That is good. Group chart of account, country chart of account. Yeah, these are the three chart of accounts we have. Industry specific and operational concern specific chart of accounts. These two, fourth and fifth, we never use most of the clients. Yeah, the most widely used and 99.99%, these are the three chart of accounts we use. Okay, then we'll try to understand what is country specific chart of account in more detail. It's just given up details like two or three lines. So I will tell ChatGPT explain more about, I can tell as country specific chart of account, or I can directly type three, explain more about point three. So let's go down, and it's getting typed. So I have entered explain more about point three. Certainly let's develop a country specific chart of accounts. Yeah, so it's giving more details of what is country specific chart of accounts, local requirement and all. Yeah, so at least like it's giving a information like a Google, but in Google search engine you will get many information, and this is specific to your question only. That is good thing. Then provide more details we already saw, and now we try to understand some little bit part of technical side. Like I want to add a substitution for text field. Let's say text field. So whether this can give me some solution or not. Just I'm pressing enter and search. Okay, the transaction code is OB28. That is correct. So it's giving an information like how we can add a text field. So we need to read and understand every details, and the same details we need to execute. Yeah, we need to go to the rules. These are all without the image we are getting the information, so we have to read each and every line, and need to implement the same details in the SAP configuration step. Now let's understand what is the table used for document posting. So I'm just checking whether it can provide me the table's details or not. Yeah. So these are good, like it's giving me the details like the important tables, like BSEC table is the most important table for us, SKB1, BSAC, these are all not widely used in S4HANA, but this is good. It's not updated mostly with the S4HANA details. It is still reading the ECC configurations and all. That is okay. Over the period of the time, it might get more details from ChatGPT. BKPF table is fine. Then let's say now we would like to see what is the functional modules. Now when we are writing a technical function or a functional specification, so at the time we need a functional modules which can help us to add it in the functional specification. So let's check whether this is capable of providing a functional specification or not. So let me copy this and type my question here. and press enter. So financial accounting, material accounting, SD information. No, for this answer, I did not got the functional module. Let me check with the BAPI. What is the BAPI used to post finance documents in SAP? Yeah, so this BAPI is correct. So BAPI account document post. So yeah, at least like some technical details we can get it from here. That is good. What is the ABAP code? And let's say if ABAPer want to try this one. Till now, whatever we saw, that is something specific to functional. Now let's say I want, as an ABAPer, I want to sum of the amounts. Can we get that code from ChatGPT or not? Yeah, so I'm not a ABAP technical person, but there is some code. I hope this can help ABAPer to write the code in. Okay. Then there is a question, what is the type of ABAP codes to get the data from regup table? So I try to create a more detailed medium complex question here, like to what is the ABAP code to get the date from the regup table. It is not very complex, but I'm just exploring whether it is capable of writing any code or not. So it's saying go into a regup table, bookers, yeah, that is technical fields. Yeah, so we are getting the code and it's getting the table details, everything correctly. And the document date also we are getting. So this is good thing. Now let's say we want to give some presentation or something, or we want to understand some more details of asset accounting. So let's put what is asset accounting. Just an example I have given here. Let's see. So what is asset accounting? Asset accounting, asset master data, asset acquisition, depreciation, asset area. So it has given all the information specific to asset accounting. That is good. Now I want to create a presentations. So I want to create a, let's say an example, we want to give a presentation on the asset accounting to the client. So we'll check whether it can give me a bullet points which can be added in my presentations or our PPTs. Create a PPT bullet point for the asset accounting in SAP. Let's say we want only for SAP specific, right? So let's put SAP and check. So asset requisition, depreciation management, depreciation areas, asset transactions. Yeah, this all information has been added as a bullet point, and we can take the important points which we need, and we can create our PPTs also. Now let's say ChatGPT can help me to create a CV or a resume for SAP or not. Create a CV for SAP FICO experience, and we can intentionally keep a spelling mistakes also, so that it can be capable of taking the correct details. So let's check that one. So you can see the spellings also updated. So it is just giving the details, but not as we want. let's say create a CV for finance module, SAP finance module in Word, because I don't want to go into a technical of that one. So I'm just checking it's capable of giving me the details or not. So it has just given me the basic information, like what is need to be added. Of what information need to be added in the CV, but yeah, but it is good enough to write a take this as a reference, and we can fill the required points which can be used for a CV. Now the last point, let's see, is it capable of giving me the some transactions code? Sometimes which we might search for a transaction codes. So I'm specifically looking for a T code to make a payment run in FICA, not FICO. FICO we use F110. Now I am checking for a FICA. So let's say, yeah, so it's taking FP05. Yeah, that is related to FICA. And now we'll change the same transaction to FICO. So it should give me F110 or something related to FICO. Yeah, we can see that it's giving FICO. Yeah, so it is not mature product, but it is giving a basic information which is needed. And we can use ChatGPT for our SAP doubts or for a more information purpose. Thank you.